feel good, and we just gonna keep on pushing, cause that's the only thing we can do is block people, and South Carolina had a good defensive line, so we went toe to toe with a good line.
Do you think the offense? I mean, I guess kind of after a tough game against Alabama, really bounced back against South Carolina there.
We bounced back. It just find who we were. Like, we know that we can do it, and just keep clicking whatever play is called. Just keep getting the job done.
Dallas, with Troy coming in here this weekend and their ability to put some points on the board and roll up some yards, do you think it'll be a shootout kind of game? Does the offense sort of take that approach now that you just have to kind of go all out and score as much as you can to win these games?
I hope it don't come out to be a shootout, but if that ends up happening, then we'll have to be a shootout, and we know we can put the yards up, so we'll just have to go toe to toe.
But is the offense go into games now with that kind of mentality, do you think?
No, we don't never go into games thinking like we're gonna have to shoot out, but because we believe in our defense, you know, they'll hold them. But if it comes down to it, you know, we can do it.
You still believe in the defense a little bit?
Oh, I never lost faith in my defense. I know things are rough right now, but I know they can pull us through.
Is your guys' heads maybe at a better place right now than they were this time last year, do you think?
Oh, yeah, because we know we could still get the job done and hopefully make it to a bowl game this year.
What's different about last year as opposed to this year, the approach-wise mentally, do you think? In the Arkansas game last year, things didn't go so well. And as November went on, maybe was it a little tougher last year than going into this November, do you think?
Yeah, it was. But now, like, I think it's more so the leadership. The leadership on the team, the guys are just keeping everybody focused in on, like, don't worry about what's going on, but just focus on this one game, and then the next game, the next and the next, you know.
What can the seniors do to keep the team focused this last month?
Just focus on the assignments, on knowing your assignments, so, like, you don't mess up, no MAs, no blown coverages, or anything like that.
You see signs that the team is still mentally in the games, that there's not a chance the team's going to quit?
Oh, no, that's one thing we don't do. We don't let the seniors, that's something that I take personally. Like, we make sure guys don't quit.
But last year at this point, some guys said people did quit on you guys when your backs were against the wall. What's the difference between, it's a lot of the same guys this year, you know, what's the difference in the mentality this year versus last year? What'd you learn from last year?
Well, it's just the leadership is just way different than last year. More guys are more vocal, and the younger guys are really starting to follow us, follow the seniors, and they learning from us. So, and the guys, they're not just giving up like how they did last year. Like AJ Johnson, he's really like, he's trying to step up as a leader, and I hope he's going to be a leader next year when I'm gone.
How is there not the frustration in between offense and defense that you guys have played so well and put up so many points, and at the end of the day scoring 40, 35 points isn't enough?
I don't know, but we just got faith in each other. That's the thing. It's just faith that keeps us together.
You feel like you guys are learning to win, because there's several games you had a chance, your one drive, your one play away from winning the game in the fourth quarter. You feel like you're making progress as far as learning to win these games?
Yeah, and, you know, it's just always one play that just messed everything up. But we're still trying to put together a 60-minute game, you know, and we're getting closer and closer. So hopefully you do it this month.
How much confidence is there in those situations, because you haven't pulled one out yet?
We still confident in ourselves, because we know we can do it. We've done it before. We know we can do it, you know. But we just got to keep working at it.
Tiny seems like he's hurting a lot. What did you say to him this weekend to get him to kind of get over the play?
That he played a good game. He played a real good game against somebody that's real good, you know. Like, you can't always go in a game and think you're going to dominate a real good player. You're like, he's going to get you, and you're going to get him. You just hope that you get him more than he gets you. And he just made a big play at the end.
You're probably not going to be playing another ranked team the rest of the season. What's at stake for you guys these last four games? What can you accomplish this program?
Just go out and play ball, and just keep playing. Don't worry about if he was ranked or not ranked. You know, just playing ball.
If y'all could go 7-5, if y'all went out, I mean, what would it mean for y'all to have a winning season, maybe go to a bowl?
I'd be happy to send me out on a good note as a senior. You know, it'd be my last game, so I'd be happy.
Tiny joke that some of the O-line was wearing their thermals, and he called them soft. Were you wearing your long sleeves?
No, I don't wear long sleeves at all. I was calling them all soft out there. I actually called them something else, but I can't say it.
Ben said that you guys had talked to the younger guys about if nothing else, win these last four games for us, the seniors. Do you feel that way too, that this is, you know, these guys need to win for you?
Yeah, of course, because we did it for the seniors that was here last year, and the ones, well, oh, yeah, did we go? No, we didn't go last year, but, you know, the year before last we did, you know, and that's what we want to keep on doing.